Can beginners perform overclocking? And in addition, why would you want to blow your bank with a 10RLK as well as the ROG Maximum Chop Extreme?
How many of your kidneys do you want to sell today?
Because stock clock is boring! Okay, welcome back to Real Meltan, a channel where we provide you with amazing PC build ideas without breaking your bank. But today, we are going to blow your bank. If you're new to this channel, make sure to smash the subscribe button as well as the 100% bell. So, if you have not tried overclocking, basically, it's a trial and error process whereby you try to squeeze out a wee bit more juice or clock speed out of your CPU. You can also do the same for your RAM as well as your GPU, but today we're going to talk about this 10RLK. To do this manually, basically, you go into the motherboard's BIOS and you adjust the voltage as well as the multiplier to get a better boost clock from your CPU. Let us know in the comments if you are a beginner overclocker or a seasoned overclocker. Like Gordon is a very seasoned overclocker.
You flatter me. But never mind, let's get right to it.
Okay. ASUS claims that their AI overclocking suite makes it easy to overclock. And they also say that their results are good or even better than what you can achieve via manual overclocking. So we gotta test this out today. So these are the PC parts that we're gonna use for today's test. Okay, let's start with any more. Let's begin some overclocking.
Okay, right. Thanks, Mel. So let's get right into the gist of things. Now, first off, or point of note, the 10900K that we have sitting right under this AIO is the very same one that we used in the earlier video, the one where we did the ASUS TUF Z490 Wi-Fi. So it's that very same CPU. It's come back for round two. Now, if you remember for that particular review, I kind of got a little bit stuck at 4.9 GHz. Getting it to 5 was quite a little bit of a stretch, maybe because of the motherboard and also maybe because of the AIO. So this time round, we're going to see if we can get any better luck out of this with a motherboard that's costs 3 times as much, which is why it's now red in color. We also have a better and higher end AIO, the EK360mm liquid cooler right over here. So to get right into it, I have gone to the BIOS screen itself. So if you were to look right over here, what I've done is that it's set to default settings. So the only settings I've changed from default is that I've set it to XMP2, which pulls up the default XMP profile for the 3200CL16 G-Skill Trident Zs I have here. Is the interesting part is that now for the ROG Strix line of motherboards, which includes this one, what we have is actually this thing over here, the CPU core ratio. On the other motherboards, all you have is auto, sync all cores, or by core usage. This particular motherboard has this additional option called AI Optimize. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to press this. Optimize AVX frequency, I'm just going to leave it as normal use. So it has predicted that my light load will be 53, my heavy load will be 50. Let's get out of here. Wait, hold on. Before we get out of here, let's come down to AI features. Let's see how the things are. So it's going to try to train. So what it'll do is that it'll try to adapt the clock speeds by AI to based on what's the cooling solution, the workloads, etc., etc. So we're going to set to keep training. And we are going to see the optimism scale. What this basically means is that how aggressive you're going to want the AI to push. So default is 100, we're going to leave it as there. You can go above 100, but we'll set to default and we'll see what happens. So the only thing we have done is that we have set the AI tuning to on. So let's get out of here. So you can see, let's get to business. Okay, right. Now we are in Windows itself, as you can see right over here. So we have enabled the AI overclocking. So the one big slight improvement that you can see from here is that instead of the 10900K's default 4.9 GHz, which you've seen in both the TUF Z490 as well as the MSI Z490 Ace video, we are now floating at about exactly 5 GHz, so which is a very nice number to have. Doesn't really look very ambitious. Let's see how stable this is. So how I'm going to do is that I have powered up Cinebench R20 here. You see the default score down there. The one orange line down there is this CPU score at 4.9 GHz. So we're going to run the test. We're going to see things like what clock speed is going to maintain it. Does it throttle? How the temperature is like? Let's kick this off. So yeah, the first thing you can see is that we are still maintaining at 5 GHz as it spins along. My call speeds are like floating at the mid 70s, that kind of thing. Okay, right, so we have a little bit of improvement here. So instead of 6304, we now have a R20 multi-core score of 6482. So as you can notice just now, that was done at 5 GHz, so now it's going to float back to 5 GHz. Now, again, this doesn't really seem like a lot, but according to ASUS, based on the number of restarts that you do to this set, it will automatically adjust by the AI adjustment how it's going to boost, it will adjust itself to your AIO. So my understanding is that the more you do this, as the time goes by, the AI overclocking will adjust itself and optimize itself to match whatever cooling solution you have, as well as the rest of the thermals on your system itself. Okay, right. So at this point, you might be thinking to yourself, I've got 5 GHz. But you know what? That's just 0.1 GHz more than the default settings. I want to go more. I want to push more. You can actually. So what I have here is ASUS AI Suite 3. So as you can see right over here, there's a couple of things you can do here. You can optimize the fan right here, a lot of things. So I think we covered this in some previous videos. But for the moment, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click this little thing that looks like somebody's brains. It's called AI overclocking. So when I click here, your computer will restart now. Do you want to proceed? So I'm going to restart. Okay, right. We have rebooted the set after the AI suite has finished trying to optimize. And as you can see, there's a bit of an improvement here. So instead of being stuck at 5 GHz, we are now floating at a median of like 5.1. So you can see some of the cores are like jumping to 5.3, 5.4, because I'm not doing anything. You can see the score over there is 6482. That was the reading at 5 GHz. So let's see what happens. Can we maintain 5.1 on all 10 cores? Let's find out. Right, so the first thing you're gonna notice is, yes, now it's a lot louder because my fans are spinning up. It's maintaining 5.1 stable. Our core temperatures are floating in the high 8, sorry, not high, in the mid 80s. And we have a V core of 1.27. So, okay, fine, we have a little bit of an improvement over here. So 6546 over 6482. So let's do one more run and see how the temperature is going to be like. We have a temperature reading of the mid 80s. So we are getting a bit toasty here, despite the fact that we have an EK360mm radiator. We have a package power of like 260, 270 watts. So we have a V-core of 1.27 volts. This gives me a little bit of inspiration as to what to probably try and do later. Okay, fine. That was a little bit disappointing. 6.2, but it's okay. Now, we have gotten to the point that we have maintained 5.1 GHz or 10 cores. Now, here comes the fun part. Can I actually beat the AI? Let's find out. Okay, right. This is where I'm trying to beat the AI, as I seem to have aged it out a bit. I've set it to times 52 manually, so we are now at 5.2 GHz. I've also taken the liberty of adjusting the V-core voltage and a couple of other things. So as you can see, I have a constant 5.2 GHz. Let's see what kind of settings we are going to get. Let's run her. So right, we have a all-core temperature of 80-something degrees on 5.2 GHz, all 10 cores. That's a bit of a disappointment. So let's see if we can try to do something about that again. Right, so do one more run. So as you can see, I am somewhat beating the AI at 5.2, but at what cost? I'm going into the high 80s on the various cores already. So this is probably not something you want to do if you're going to be using this particular CPU for, like, let's say any CPU intensive render jobs. Okay, right. We have reached 6652. So we have gained a little bit over 100 points because of the jump from 5.1 GHz to 5.2 GHz. But you know what? If we're gonna do this all night long, let's push this some more. So hold on to your hats. Let's get in. Okay, right. So now we are at 5.3. That's my record over there, 6652. So that was taken at 5.2 GHz. Let's see if we can do 5.3 without this guy crashing. Oh dear, I think we just crashed. Right, it is frozen, as Mel over there sitting at my machine has said. Yeah, it's frozen solid.
Okay, so we are done with the overclocking. I'm sure we had a lot of fun. So, Gordon, was the overclocking extreme enough for you? Extreme enough for you!
Well, I would say we had a lot of fun with it. We tried to do 5.3 GHz just now, couldn't really get it stable. I mean, we could get the set to boot at 5.3, but it couldn't really complete any Cinebench run. If I had a bit more time, I could probably figure out how to do it, but as it is, I don't. But there is room. This guy can do 5.3 easily. I just didn't have the time to figure it out. That being said, however, what I did to try to get 5.3 are steps that something like, let's say, a beginner or novice to the overclocking scene might not want to or be willing to do. 5.2 was fairly easy to get. We ran IDA, it was flat out stable, but yeah, the CPU really ran hot as balls. I mean, just now, even the Cinebench run, as you saw just now, it was in the high 80s. On all 10 cores. Even on a 360mm AI or in this, yeah, that's really toasty. And that's not really temperatures you want to be running on an everyday basis. Especially if you're using this for CPU intensive stuff like V-Ray rendering, that kind of thing.
You know, bro.
So, that being said, what do I think of the AI overclocking? It's pretty conservative, but that's probably for the good of the customer or the owner of this board itself. You're probably looking at somebody who just bought a CPU. I mean, this thing is 800 SGD. You don't really want to...
yeah, mess it up.
So the thing is that default is 4.9 GHz, right? 5 was easy by the AI training. If you select the AI suite AI optimization, it'll go straight to 5.1. Mm-hmm. And as we saw just now, the temperatures were pretty good. We have high 70s, low 80s on the cores. So that's a good place to be. You could stretch it a bit and get 5.2, but honestly speaking, unless you are playing like a custom loop, that kind of thing, with multiple radiators, you probably may not want to go there.
Or even deleting your CPU.
Yeah, which will void your warranty.
Yeah, but if you are that level already, deleting CPU doesn't make a difference anyway.
Well, if you're at that level, you're probably like a certain German dude that starts with the letter D. Ein CPU server lasts for 1,000 years!
Yeah, we know who you're talking about.
So I think we can bring this to a close, can we?
Yeah, thank you to ASUS for, I would say, sponsoring us with these two bad boys over here.
Yeah, yes, it was fun. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yes. So yeah, if you like this video, make sure to give us a thumbs up. And as I mentioned earlier, let us know if you are a season overclocker or a basic overclocker. Yeah, anyway, if you have not watched our other ASUS videos, make sure to check out our ASUS folder. ASUS playlist up over there. And from Gordon and I, we say goodnight and goodbye.